Don't just choose your friends because they're your friends. First of all, you should be very passionate about this. And then when you go to find team, you should find people who are equally passionate about their interests. And then if you're able to convince them that, hey, you know, you can pursue your interests really well in this competition, so we can work together and achieve like a great goal. Make sure you find passionate people, people who really like the subject they deal with. When I say passion, I mean like specific subjects. So everyone in engineering might, you know, some of us might like coding a bit better, some of us might like robotics a bit better. And I'd say the skill level also doesn't really matter. It's just that passion will drive you to learn and get the job done no matter what, if you really like that. So for example, I'm not the greatest at ROS, but I'd say it interested me enough to go out of my way, read extra things. And I can say that about my team members as well. We all shared interests and each of us took the extra step to learn rather than, you know, just putting in how much they know.
Before participating in EYRC, I was just interested in the, you know, like electronics aspect of the bot. But as the competition progressed, I became more and more interested in, you know, designing aspects, like designing the chassis of the bot, the heating mechanism and all that.
Before Yantra project, actually I did not do many projects, like I did not have hands-on experience. From this Yantra project, even I can say that I have some sort of hands-on experience, so that I'm confident enough to cope up with the competitive world outside.
It makes you very competent as a person. It you know, pushes your horizons in that sense. And you don't, for me, one of the biggest issues is the fact that I get tensed and I used to get very nervous. I used to live in the comfort zone of not going to such competitions because of it. But for me, that went away after this. Let's say around my first or second year in during my engineering, I was a person who would either do, you know, a competitive thing or I would focus on my academics. Because I didn't want to deal with the pressure of both. That was for one. And two, the fact that, you know, when you participate in a competitive activity, there is a chance you may have to stay there, you may have to get the thing working and only then go home. There's always a fear that those things will hinder your academic performance. But what people have to understand is that when you're put in a situation of adversity, you eventually just learn to come out of it.
Even if you maybe get eliminated in the first or second round, you still got a substantial amount of knowledge to, you know, work on projects by yourself and apply that into your maybe daily life. So I'd say just for the learning, it's a great thing. It's not as like in your face as like a one day hackathon or something like that. So I'd say maybe for somebody who's never participated in such a competition, it's a great like entry point.
It's a brilliant learning experience. It just it pushes you to your limits and definitely makes you a better engineer.
Yantra is a competitive environment where your personal inhibitions are, you know, reduced to nothing.
Yantra helps you become like a more well-rounded engineer, not just on the technical aspect, but in the teamwork aspect. So if the teamwork isn't there, you yourself will feel the heat. So it helps, I'd say, an all-around development.